The purpose of this problem is to consider some aspects of elementary reactions and the Arrhenius behavior of reaction rate constants, as well as some minimal aspects of transition state theory. In part A, we are asked to estimate the forward rate constant at a temperature of 450 Kelvin, when we already know the rate constant for at 400 Kelvin for the forward reaction is 0.034 reciprocal seconds. This is for the reversible reaction A goes to B. The activation energy for the forward reaction is given, and so we just use an Arrhenius relationship to get the rate constant at a higher temperature. And so we can do this in terms of K at a temperature of 450 Kelvin compared to K at a temperature of 400 Kelvin, according to the Arrhenius relationship, is just equal to the exponential of the activation energy divided by the gas constant times 1 over the starting temperature minus the temperature that we want the new rate constant at, which is 450 Kelvin. Therefore, K at 450 is equal to 0.51 reciprocal seconds. We see that there's a very significant increase in the rate constant, which we expect because of the very strong dependence of rate constants on temperature. We're increasing the temperature by 50K in this case. Part B asks what the concentration equilibrium constant is, Kc, for at 400 Kelvin, which was the original temperature in this problem. And if we remember that for this reversible reaction system, we can define Kc as being equal to the concentration of products over reactants. And here we have sort of the simplest of all reactions of A going to B. Furthermore, this is at equilibrium. And at equilibrium, in order to make the net rate of reaction equal to zero, this is equal to K forward divided by K reverse. We're actually given the values for both K forward and K reverse in this case in reciprocal seconds. And so our equilibrium constant is about 1.6. Part C asks us to determine delta G to the transition state based on a transition state theory interpretation of the rate constant. And so here we'll use the Eyring equation. And for this first order reaction, the Eyring equation says that the rate constant is equal to the following, where delta G to the transition state is given inside here. We are asked to find delta G at 400 Kelvin. If we just start plugging in values here, then at 400 Kelvin, we have 0.034 reciprocal seconds for K. KBT over H can be approximated as roughly 10 to the 13 reciprocal seconds without having to deal with all of those constants. And then we can multiply that by this exponential. But now what we can do is just divide both sides of the equation by 10 to the 13 reciprocal seconds, right, to just get a dimensionless quantity on the left-hand side of the equation. Take the natural log of both sides of the equation and solve for delta G to the transition state. Right, and when we do that, we get that delta G to the transition state is equal to about 110 kilojoules per mole, right, which solves the final part of this problem.